Dear friends, welcome to another video. Today we built a real-time clock. As you can see in the display, we have here the date, the time, and the temperature. All these are accomplished with the use of only one chip. This little chip is the DS3231 chip, this one here. Let's see how it is built. The DS3231 chip, this little chip here, is a very low power chip which keeps time with great accuracy. In this building block we bought for Arduino, it comes with a battery, a rechargeable battery, and so it can keep time for many years. It is very easy to use as it uses the I2C interface. It has an embedded ROM which can store some data, and it has a temperature sensor which is quite accurate, and it's very easy to use. Let's connect this little block in the Arduino and see how easy it is to operate this little device. First, we take the Arduino. In this video, we are going to use an Arduino Mega. You can use any Arduino device you like. Then we can use an Arduino display like this in order to display the data in the screen. We plug the screen, the display, in the Arduino, and we are ready to connect the DS3231 chip. Okay, in order to be easier to connect, we can use a small breadboard. We plug the chip in and now we are ready to connect them. First, let's connect, of course, the power. The second pin of the chip is the VCC. It's going to 5 volts in the Arduino Mega. The next pin, well, the first pin is the ground, so we connect it with the Arduino ground. The third pin is named SDA, standard data for the I2C protocol, and goes to the SDA pin of the Arduino Mega. And lastly, we connect the SEL pin, the fourth pin, with the SEL pin in the Arduino Mega. Okay, now we are ready to power the device on and see if it is working. Okay, it works great. As you can see, it keeps the time, the date, and the temperature. If I unplug, unpower, and power on again the device, the time is correct. It keeps time internally with the embedded battery. Let's see how to program this device and how to set the time. We are in the computer now. First of all, we have to download the appropriate library in order to use the DS3231 real-time clock with the Arduino. We go to this page, you can find the link in the description of the video below, and download the library. It's the Rodan DS3231 library. There are many libraries out there, but this one is easy and very straightforward to use. We unzip the library in the desktop, for example, rename it, for example, real-time clock, and cut it and paste it in the Arduino libraries folder. Okay, here it is, real-time clock. Now we open Arduino and we can see the example of the library. Okay, real-time clock, DS3231. This is an example that gets time from the Arduino. I now have loaded the final code of the project. You can find the full code in the link in the description of the video. It's a modified version of the code that is provided with the library, the example we loaded at the beginning. I have modified that code and now it can set time and get time and display it to the display. First of all, let's set the time. When we buy this real-time clock, the time is not set. So we have to manually set it in the first time we use it. In order to do that, the library that we use has a command that it is named parse command. In this command, we can send commands in the real-time clock module. So let's send the command to set time. In order to set the time, we have to make a string like that. This is a capital T for time and the time in a string format and the number 16 because this command is 16 bytes long. So first of all we have to set year. Year is here, 2014. Then we have to set the month, 10, because we are now October. Next we have day. It is 4th of October. Next we have day of the week. Today is Saturday, so we can set it as the 6th day of the week. Then we have hour. It's 11 in the morning, so we set here 11. Then is minutes, 29, and we can set the seconds as well. Okay, let's get here, let's put 30. Now we have to run the code, compile and run the code only once. The first time that the code is run, the time is set and then we don't have to care anymore about it. Let's upload the code. Now we have to open the serial monitor and see. Okay, setting time. Okay, temperature is 24. Okay, setting of time is done. Okay, now we comment those lines because we want to set time only once. Now time is kept internally in the clock for many years, as long as the battery of the module has power. Now let's have a quick look at the code and how it works. First of all, in the setup, we begin the serial communication with the computer and the I2C communication. We initialize the LCD screen and clear it. Then, in the loop function, we show time once in a while, once in a second. There is a variable named interval, which can be set at any value we like. I have set it to 1000 milliseconds. In order to show time once every second. So once a second we get time, we get temperature, we convert it to a string, we clear the LCD screen every second, we set the cursor at the beginning, we print the day of the month, and then we print the month itself. This is a custom function. Let's see where it is. Okay, it's very simple. It gets it has an input of an integer and then it prints in the screen the appropriate month. If the month is the first month of the year, it prints in the screen January. Very simple. It's a simple switch case command. Then we print year. Okay. Then we set the cursor to the second line of the LCD screen. We print hour and then we print minutes and seconds. That's it, very easy. And then lastly we print the temperature. That's it, and of course we check if there is new data in the serial communication. That's the simple code of the example and you can download it in the link. If you have any questions about anything in the code, you can post a comment and I'll get back to you very soon.
As you can see,
This module is a very easy to use module, and it can provide time to your Arduino project for many years because it uses very low power, and so its embedded battery can last for many years. It is a very cheap module, and you can buy it for around $2 or $3 from the link in the description. It can also provide temperature because it has an embedded temperature sensor, which is more accurate than the DHT11 sensor we used in the previous video. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please subscribe to our channel in order to see our next project, and press like if you liked the video. Thank you very much.